بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الأطهار. It gives me a great pleasure to be with you. I want to thank Sayyid Baqir Kashmiri for this very kind introduction. I want to thank Sheikh Mustafa for inviting me to this beautiful place. I feel shame that I delayed this visit that long. I should have been here way before this time, but alhamdulillah, kullu amri bi qadar, everything that will be decreed. But what a very pleasant night. We are in the eve, in the days of remembrance of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. And in this beautiful gathering of people who love the Habib صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, loved أهل بيته الأطهار, in remembering him, we have to look to the Quran, what the Quran said about him. Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He says, we have sent you for no other purpose except to be the mercy to the world. And by looking to his life, in the life of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, we'll see the manifestation of this verse. His birth, his childhood, is manifestation of this mercy. Before he became a prophet, you know, when he was born, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, his father had passed away, was born as an orphan. But his mother, Amina, Sayyida Amina, like any other women of Mecca, she wanted to have him to be a nurse. And the beautiful, by the way, all the women in the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have beautiful names. Sayyida Amina, her name is Amina. Security, Amina. When she was given to have him to be nurse, Sayyida Halima Sa'diya, is that agreed upon? Yeah? Her name is Halima. Halima all means for bearing. Amina and Halima for bearing. And then in his life, another Sayyida, Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam jami'an, and all of these women alayhi wasalam, Sayyida Fatima bint Asad alayhi wasalam. Those are the women have surrounded the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one of the things that my father used to, when he used to talk about, he used to cry, when he used to talk about Fatima bint Asad alayhi salam. Because after his mother passed away, she's the one who took care of him. When she was passing away, he said, "Akuntu ummi ba'da ummi." We were my mother after my mother. I know that we weren't hungry so you can feed me. You let go of what you need so you can clothe me. And when they went to bury her, alayhi salam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't put her yet. What did he do? He laid down in her grave. And that's why the love of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam is wajib, is fard. person who claimed that love for Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not love Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa sallam, he does not love Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Fatima bint Asad alayhi salam, he laid down in her grave and made dua. And then asked him to put her body there. Therefore, in his childhood, he was surrounded with this love and mercy. It was given to him by those women. And he was a mercy to them, a source of mercy to all of them. Halima Sa'diyah was the poorest woman. When she came to Mecca looking for children, she has a donkey, has a limb. Before we can say she had a transmission problem. Or she has a flat tire. She was putting the donut tire. When she arrived, she saw that she arrived late. Because all the children of rich family been taken. But she said, I checked and there's no child been left except him. Talking about sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For she said, maybe I will take this child, maybe perhaps I can get some barakah, some blessing from him. She didn't know that she will have the last prophet Allah has sent to humanity. When she took him, she sat on the donkey. What happened to the donkey? Do you know the story? The donkey become fixed. AAA. Fix the donkey. Because Rahmah lil Alameen was on the back of that donkey. And then she was going on the highway. I'm just rephrasing that. And she saw other women who were with her. She said, Halima, what happened? Is it your donkey that you came with? He said, yeah. What happened to you? I said, I don't know, it's flying. And it was a very difficult year. It was a drought year. Herself, she doesn't have enough milk for her own son. And all of a sudden, she was able to nurse sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad, and was able to nurse her son, and her son went to sleep. Her husband said, what happened to our child? She said, I don't know, the blessing of this child. But I want to say that his mercy is rahmah before he become a prophet. Now, since we are talking in this beautiful place about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, I want to show how much of his mercy and love was for Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa sallam. I want in every masjid of ours, and our moderator, Jazawul Khair, made an example of the Sayyid having his child, killing the child, his daughter. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given a khutbah. Who came in? Al-Husayn alayhi salam. Walked into the masjid and had a long robe, was tripping on the robe. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left the minbar and went to Al-Husayn alayhi salam and he carried him to the minbar. You know, when I went to Iraq, I went to Najaf, visiting Al-Husayn alayhi salam as an experience, if you don't have it, you should plan to go. It will transform your life. You will never come back the same. Seriously. Who have visited Hussein alayhi salam, raise your hand. Those who have not raised their hand, make a plan. When you go and visit Amir al-Mu'in alayhi salam, visit Hussein alayhi salam, Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, your heart will be soft and warm. For when I went and visited Al-Husayn alayhi salam, Imam Al-Husayn alayhi salam, when I visited him, I remembered this story. I remembered the story that صلى الله عليه وسلم left the member to take care to hold her. Not only that, I remember the story that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he crawled in his knees and in his hand. And Hussein عليه السلام was riding on his back. And somebody come to visit him said, look to my child, had the best ride. Best ride. When you talk about Rahman al-Alameen, talking about a man that when he came home, he brought happiness in the household. That's why I say Khadija alayhi salam, when she described him when he just received the revelation, Khadija al-Kubra, we call her, she said, والله لن يخزيك الله. Nothing will happen to you because you are kind, you are generous, you are there for those who have been wronged. You welcome the guest. You connect with your kinship. She mentioned his virtues that before he became a prophet. But her mercy and kindness toward him, Zambiluni, Zambiluni, Dathiruni, Dathiruni, cover me, who did that? My sister, Khadija, alayhi salam. This masjid, an Adam Center, and every masjid in the United States around the world, Khadija alayhi salam, see the Khadija alayhi salam have paid for it. There's no money help the mission of Islam more than the money of Khadija alayhi salam, period. Sacrifice everything. For the household is a household that experiences the mercy to the wall, Rahman al-Alameen. Now I'm going to mention two things, and then you're going to hear the real sheikh. Our milkshake. He's a sheikh. You like that joke, young man? Good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about him in the Quran, فَبِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَمْ فَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. His kindness and mercy was everybody around him. God Almighty says to him, if you are so harsh and you're not soft and kind because the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you descend upon you, you will not see anyone around you with disperse. But he walked to the masjid and there's a woman clean the masjid every day. And she was an African woman. She was not an Arab woman. And then sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came in and asked what has happened to her. He didn't see her that day. He said, ya Rasulullah, she passed away last night. He said, she passed away last night? Why didn't you ask me to lead the prayer? He said, we don't want to disturb you. He didn't like that from them. He went and delivered the prayer to her grave. There's no little people in his eyes. You cannot overlook people. No matter how they look, what kind of profession they may have, they're important in his eyes. Or the sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a little girl will hold his hand and say, I want to tell you a story. I want to show you something. And he will go with that little girl, whatever she takes him. There's a lady has mental health issues. She used to stop him to say, can I talk to you? And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to her, choose where you would like me to talk to you, I will talk to you. His rahmah transcended human race. He entered a farm and a camel came toward him. He asked who the owner of this camel. Because this camel have complained to me. The man, the Sahabi said, I am the Rasulullah. He said, you've been starving your animal. And Allah made this animal like subservient to you. Therefore, don't make them stop. My point I want to make tonight, by living his example, an example of Al-Bayt alayhi salam, will be the model in our family, our neighborhood, place of work, because people are going to see us as ruhama, as compassionate people, as caring individuals. If I ask Allah Almighty, tonight, bestow a blessing upon all of us, upon this gathering, and to give us the opportunity to be company of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Sentul Imam, thank you so much for that beautiful speech, for enlightening us about, like you said, the mercy of mankind. I wanted to, as you know, of course, I'm not a lecturer or anything, but Sheikh Mustafa asked me to give a little something. So rather than me speaking, I'm going to let the mercy of mankind speak and tell us about his position. It's been narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said, "Ma khalaq Allah azza wa jal khalqan afdal minni." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create a creation better than me. So Imam Ali asked him, "Ya Rasulullah, fa anta afdal aw Jibra'il? Are you better or the angel Gabriel?" So Rasulullah said, "O Ali, inna Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala faddala anbiya'ahu al-mursaleen 'ala mala'ikatihi al-muqarrabin." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored, brought near his messengers over some of his angels. وَفَضَّلَنِي عَلَىٰ جَمِيعَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالْمُرْسَلِينَ. And he favored me, and he made me closer than all of the messengers and the prophets. And then Rasulullah goes on to say, وَالْفَضْلُ بَعْدِي لَكْ يَا عَلِي وَلِلْأَئِمَّةِ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ. The favor that Allah has placed for me is for you after me and for all of the imams in your household. And then he goes on to say this, وَإِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَخُدَّامُنَا وَخُدَّامُ مُحَبِّينَ. And the angels serve us and serve our lovers. O Ali, Rasulullah is saying, those who carry the throne, they do tasbih, they praise their Lord, and do istighfar for those who love us and who love you and your Ahlul Bayt, O Ali. Sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Inshallah, now let's welcome our esteemed scholar, our resident scholar, Sheikh Mustafa Wallah Salat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين بالقاسم المصطفى محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى
تعالى لبيت الأطهار الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. قال الله الحكيم في محكم كتابه الكريم: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فذكر إنما أنت مذكر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this year the year of the reappearance of our beloved Imam Amal Mahdi ajallahu ta'ala faraju sharif with the blessing of another loud salawat. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst his companions and his sincere soldiers with the blessing of another loud salawat. Scholar, Imam Majid, Sayyid al-Kashmiri, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. On behalf of Imam Hadi Center and myself, I would first like to thank and appreciate Sayyidina al-Kashmiri for mediating this program, for putting me and Imam Majid in an office of his in Adam Center, which was very welcoming. We had tears of joy when we met together in Adam Center about a month and a half, talking about Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam and Abu Abdullah al-Hussein and the miracles that he has seen. And also thank Imam Majid for accepting our invitation. May Allah bless him, prolong his life, increase his iman and knowledge with the blessing of another now, salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Congratulations to all of you brothers and sisters on this auspicious occasion, the birth anniversary of our beloved Rasulullah and Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the blessing of these two births to give us the best idea, and that is to hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam to bring peace, tranquility, justice and love and happiness to this world. Chapter 88, verse 21. Therefore, do remind, for you are only a reminder. Probably Imam Majid has experienced this, and Sayyid al-Kashmiri also has experienced this, and they have received this complaint from the parents. Sheikh, Imam, my son or my daughter doesn't pay attention that much to Salah. Doesn't pay attention that much to religion, hijab. I have some issues with my wife. I have some issues with my husband. I have some issues with my community member, with my relatives, friends. I tell them the truth. I insist. I argue. I debate. And I keep insisting. I get angry. I get frustrated. I really want them to learn about Salah and pay attention to Salah. I want them to pay attention to hijab, morality, akhlaq, aqidah, iman, characteristics, demeanors, so on and so forth. When we see something wrong, we try to fix it right away. And by us not seeing it to be fixed, we get frustrated and we let go of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Rasulullah, the one that he cared so much for humanity, the one who he cared even for his enemy, for kuffar, he didn't want to see even one person to be going to hellfire. He is here to save all of us and lead us to heaven. As a parent, we see the frustration. Sometimes our kids are not doing something right. We can see they're doing wrong, and if they continue with this, their ending is not going to be good. I can see it. I'm in it. One of you. So with anger, with frustration, will it work? No.
Rasulullah, mercy to mankind. Mercy to the world. No, to the worlds.
Allah says, Taha, ma anzalna al-Qur'an alayka litashqa.
We didn't send you to the Quran. You're doing really too much. Take it easy. It's okay. Out of his care and his mercy, he couldn't see people being deviated. He couldn't see Abu Jahl. He couldn't see Abu Lahab. He couldn't see Abu Sufyan being deviated and not accepting. Not that I want you to accept me, no. I am here to take your hand, to take you to heaven. That's my mission, that's why I'm here for. He couldn't see it. He would care a lot. Middle of the night, early morning. Everywhere he goes, he's trying to save one more person. Allah says, فَذَكَّر, just remind. إِنَّمَا, indeed, surely, verily, you are only a reminder. Just remind. Why don't you pray? It's not going to work. With anger, frustration, it's not going to work. That's not how Rasulullah made people to believe in. His akhlaq and his morality invited people. Why? As he says, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّنَ مَكَارِمًا أَخْلَاقًا. I was sent to complete and perfect and take it to the max, the highest level of morality. Before his message starts, he's already a prophet. Before his message starts, everybody knows him to be Sadiq al-Amin. When he goes, he leaves Mecca toward Medina, who he trusts? Amir al-Mu'mineen, because the disbelievers until that day, they trusted him, even though they don't accept him as a prophet, but they accepted him as Sadiq and Amin, trustworthy, truthful. They gave him amana, they gave him stuff to keep and preserve and protect. Rasulullah tells Amir al-Mu'mineen, give them back everything that they have entrusted me with it. That's one thing that we have to learn. First, remind. I remind my wife, I remind my husband, I remind my sister, I remind my colleagues, relatives, brothers, community members, anyone, I just remind. I'm not in charge and I'm not responsible to making people to do what they have to do. We can't. That's difference us between the followers of Rasulullah and those who claim to be the followers of Rasulullah, that with swords and anger and killing, they try to make people to do something. You can. فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. So from now on, we always have to remind other people. My wife, my husband, my brother, my sister, my relatives, everyone. We just keep reminding and reminding and reminding and reminding and reminding until one day that will have an effect. We cannot lose hope. We cannot give up. He's not doing what I told him, Shaykh. How many times have you heard this? Many times. He doesn't listen. She doesn't listen. I keep telling him, I gave up on him. I washed my hand. What do you mean washing your hand? We can't wash our hands. Rasulullah never gave up. Until his last breath, he kept reminding. Allah, when he sends Prophet Musa and Harun to Fir'aun, chapter 20, verse 44, Allah says, فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. You're going to Fir'aun. Shaykh, definitely, Fir'aun was better than my husband in the house. Haven't you heard that? That when he walks in the house, Fir'aun is in the house. Prophet Musa had easier job dealing with Fir'aun than I have to deal with my wife or my husband. And speak to him gentle. Layyina. Why? لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. Perhaps, maybe, Fir'aun we're talking. Maybe, perhaps he may accept admonition or fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fir'aun! Allah tells Musa, Prophet Musa and Harun, it's okay, just talk with them, gentle.
Rasulullah knows this Quran. Rasulullah is Quran. Quranul Naq. How he invites. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي.
Chapter 12, verse 108. That's the way he invites. Saying, this is my way. هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, as we talked in the office. One sabil, one path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Path of Rasulullah and Ahl Bayt alayhi wa sallam. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. I invite to Allah with what? With knowledge. If I don't have the knowledge, how I can educate? I give this example, you'd be surprised. We had Friday night youth session. We talked about shaving for men, haram to shave. I go home around 11:30, 12 o'clock, a mother calls my wife. Sheikh have said that shaving for men, clean shave is haram. Is this part of the religion or Sheikh is making it up? I said, if I was making it up, I would make so many other things, but this is nuts. She said, until age of 18 and 20, she's telling her both sons that shaving is part of the religion because it's cleansing. Keeping beard is haram. Their son, her son, 20 and 22, not having enough education, not having any education regarding this matter, she thinks shaving is part of Islam and is halal and wajib. Having beard is haram. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ. I invite to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with basira, insight, knowledge. I should have it in order to give it to someone else. If I don't have it, how am I going to educate other people? How many people come to us, Sayyid and Imam? They say, oh, I told somebody to do such and such, and this is Islam. He's not accepting or she's not accepting. And we will be surprised that which Quran is Quran number 2, volume 3, volume 4, maybe in the 5th volume that you've seen this. Or hadith from someone, I don't know, someone. No, I've heard this from my parents. Okay, where'd they get it? From their parents. From their parents. We have to go back to Quran and the teachings of Rasulullah and Ahl Bayt alayhi wa salam. To learn, teach. Learn, teach. Combining both Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam celebrating his birth and Rasulullah in this beautiful hadith which relates to our talk. And Abi Abdullah al-Sadiq, Imam Sadiq narrates this from Rasulullah. Qala Rasulullah, man amila ala ghayr ilmin kana ma yufsidu akthar mimma yuslih. What a beautiful hadith. What do we have other than the teachings of the Holy Quran and Ahl Bayt alayhi wa sallam to refer to for us to see light, to be guided? Imam al-Sadiq narrates from Rasulullah, anyone who acts ala ghayr ilmin, without having knowledge, he brings more about corruption than fixing and good to what he's doing. Imagine you want to go to Florida. You'd be surprised how much I bring examples for Florida. The reason why, because I met my wife in Florida. So that's my favorite state, because that's all, that's other than, I don't know that much. So always I bring Florida 95, because we took around 12 hours to go to Florida. Inshallah, we pray, I need your prayer for all of these shabab. We have a lot of these youth who want to get married. Then inshallah, their marriage will be as soon as possible, inshallah. Say then everybody say, inshallah.
Inshallah.
You see that? Inshallah. Even some people are going for the second and the third, they also said, inshallah.
Take 95 South.
Inshallah, take 95 South, inshallah, you might find something in Florida. Well, actually right now, for some of us here, some of our youth, Minnesota is becoming the next hub for getting married. We have two of our youth, they went to Minnesota, so I think right now we have to go to the Midwest. If you try to go to Florida, not knowing that 95 South takes you there, you take 95 North, will you end up in Florida? You won't. You're going further and further away from where you want to be, from your destination. If we want to end up and get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to see what satisfies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أطيع الله وأطيع الرسول وأولو الأمر منكم. obeying Allah, obeying Rasulullah, and those amongst us who have authority. Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. We have to go back to them to gain the knowledge, to learn and teach. Learn and teach. And I finish with one more hadith. Also from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, where Imam says, إني لأعلم ما في السماء وأعلم ما في الأرض. It's a very, very strong claim. Imam says, I know everything that is in heaven and everything in earth. وأعلم ما في الجنة وأعلم ما في النار. I know what is in heaven and what is in hell. وأعلم ما كان وأعلم ما يكون. I know what has happened past and what will happen in the future. علمت ذلك من كتاب الله. I learned all of this, heaven, earth, heaven, hell, past, future. I learned everything where? From كتاب الله. Why? Because إن الله تعالى يقول فيه تبيان كل شيء. Book of Allah has the clarification and knowledge about everything that we need. So what do we need to do? Action plan. Number one, we need to keep reminding one another. Reminder based on knowledge. Reminder based on insight and basira. Not reminder based on ignorance and darkness, and I don't know what I'm talking about. When this happens, we see as a community coming together, أمر بالمعروف النهي عن المنكر, enjoining good and discouraging evil. As a community, when we give hand in hand together with that mindset, we see how much we will be advanced. I have many more hadith, inshallah. We'll leave it for another time. Again, on behalf of Imam Ali Center, our community, we appreciate Imam Majid and Sayyid al-Kashmiri that prepared this opportunity for us to come together and celebrate the birth of Rasulullah and Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq. Let us enlighten our gathering with three salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.